Now, if the up and down world of business and the Shark Tank of Washington, D.C., or the iron harrowing, you know, adventures in the Iron Curtain, or the ones that we read in the book Travelin Man, aren't enough for you, you decided to, hey, you know what I've never done? I've never spent most of my day with convicted murderers, right? It wasn't enough. You had to go. You had to up yourself, up your game, and you taught business
courses
in
maximum security prison, Jackson State Prison.
Wow!
I was told it's the largest walled prison in the world with a wall. It's a huge old maximum security prison. They shut it down, I think, recently. But it was just kind of an lark. I had my business. I didn't really need the job. I was contacted about teaching this class. The guy that taught before didn't make it. They don't last. He had to leave. So
I thought he like got killed. Well, shame.
I don't know, actually. So they needed somebody very quickly. I was contacted to teach this class. So yeah. I said, okay, I'll do it. I did it just to test myself. When I was young, I used to always test myself. I do something. It doesn't matter if I was doing push-ups. I could do 25. Okay, I do 30. If I'm walking somewhere. So I figured, well, I'll test myself, see if I can do this. It'll be a learning experience. I'll do it for maybe a year or so at night. So I signed up for it. So I remember my first day, I got my suit on, my little briefcase, and going to Jackson Prison, and you walk in, they got the big iron gate, open up the gate, you walk into no man's land, they shut the gate behind you, then they go through the metal detector, they check your briefcase, then they open the second gate to walk into the prison area. It's my first time there. There's this long hallway, maybe about 100 meters long. There's a few prisoners that are cleaning, some of the guys doing work, in the prison. Sweeping and stuff. I walk with one guard down this long hallway. I'm kind of nervous. My first day, it's a big prison. It's maximum security. It's a lot of lifers and so forth. And then he opens up this big gate that goes into this huge courtyard, like you see in the movies, like Shawshank Redemption or something. Huge courtyard, and there's hundreds of prisoners just mingling and walking around out there. So he opens this gate. I step out. He steps back in, and he points across the cell yard, that building, cell block, central cell block, that's where you teach, there. And he slams the gate. I'm standing out in the middle of the courtyard with my little briefcase.
Are you fast, boy? You better get running.
So I walk across this courtyard with all these prisoners, shoulder by shoulder,
No Shawshank going on like, hey, baby.
No, not any of that, but I go to the back cell block, and there's this female guard. And she's really nervous, which is making me nervous. She's like, "Yes, your classroom's on the third floor. Walk up that stairway." And she opens the, slams the gate. I'm in this back cell block, and I think there will be guards with me. I thought there'd be a guard walking me in. There'd be a guard in my classroom. There'd be a guard. So I walk up the stairway, which I found out later is one of the most dangerous places in the prison. My prisoners, my students told me this, because it's a little winding wood staircase, three floors. You're shoulder to shoulder with dozens of guys. You can't move. They come up behind you, and they do the shanking along the neck, slight slit to your neck. So anyways, they walk up this little narrow stairway to the third floor, and there's no guard there. And I walk to the end of the corridor, and there's a couple prisoners, trustees, who have responsibility. They say, yeah, here's your class list, that room over there. I'm like, well, where's the guard? The first floor. There's not even a guard on the floor, so now I'm really nervous, going in this classroom. I walk in this classroom, it's about 30 guys, a lot of big guys, tough guys, some smaller guys. And I got my little suit on, my briefcase, I walk in there.
They always tell me if I go to prison, just pick the biggest guy and punch him. Take a beating, but
the guy told me actually that hired me. He said they'll probably test you. He said the guy that came before you didn't last. He said when you're tested, you can't back down. You can't show fear and you can't back down, but you can't show disrespect or aggression. You have to maintain a strong, neutral position. Just always strength, but not aggressive. That's the same thing when I traveled. I always did that. I maintained just a strong, neutral image, And so I started teaching my first class. It's about 20 minutes into it. I'm starting to get a little bit comfortable, And then this one big guy, this big dude, he just stands up from his chair. And he walks across the classroom, and he makes a point of bumping my shoulder, and he walks out the room. And I'm just kind of stunned. What was that? What happened? And thankfully, he was gone for a couple minutes, so I kind of regained my composure. I knew this was kind of crunch time. Either I if I back down or don't do something, I'm not going to be respected. I won't last here.
Right.
So as soon as he walked back into the room, I just walked right up to the door and faced him. He's much taller than I was, so I was looking up at him. I just said, you know, in a strong voice, but not threatening, I said, don't ever leave my classroom again. If you want to leave my classroom, you show respect and ask me, no problem. But if you leave my classroom again and don't ask, you never come back in. He just looked at me, kind of shrugged, and said, I gotcha. And walked back in. I never had a problem with him. And I didn't have
Jesus, man, my students treat me with